Okay, I'm gonna do a little video here and read a conversation I had with a character on a Carcano video, and it's sort of interesting. I haven't done a video on this in a while, but I'm always sort of looking for weird comments. I got nothing else to do or something anyway. There's nobody commenting on my videos, and I'll go around. And there's usually the, you know, the big channels that have videos with lots of views, and you get all kinds of weird comments. Like, this would be like an endless, it's like an endless supply of videos, but sometimes you see, like, these weird comments, and I, for some weird reason, I like to ask them, like, why they think that, or where's the, you know, where can I find about this, or, you know. So this was on Forgotten Weapons video, M38 Carcano, Best Bolt Action Rifle of World War II. And I think it was one of the, I'm pretty sure it's a 735 one. It was an M38, I guess. But it was one of the, was it Royal Tiger or whatever that importer was that you had a bunch you looked at there a while ago. But, so the guy's channel, it's like PN or something, which I don't know where he's from. He might be from Finland or something or other, but, or Europe or something, but I'm not really sure. But, he says, Carcano may work in Ethiopia, but they do not work in 30 or minus 30 Celsius temps and snow. So I asked him, I was like, why is that? He said, you can ask that from Finnish World War II veterans. Yeah, okay, I'm going to get right on there. I'll call up some like 90-odd-year-old or 100-year-old guy from Finland that was in the war and hope he can still remember. Like, yeah, that's going to happen. But, like, I understand there is sort of this story that circulates around about the Carcanos that the Finns received and how they didn't like them, and there was all a bunch of reasons why, and I've heard multiple theories, but it's I guess we'll get to that, but they ended up giving them like second line troops or whatever. Just but so then I said, so you don't know either, or you made it up? That's what I asked him. So he's like, so he replies, he says, Carcanos freeze and seize up in winter temperatures, and Finnish army dump those crappy rifles for sailors, second line troops, home defense forces, that's what you get it spelled. They not use those clubs as active duty troops because they did not work reliably, snow or freeze. This is historical fact. Okay, so if you write historical fact, that means historical fact. I like that one. I gotta remember that one. So, anyway, so I replied back. I said, I'm pretty sure it's was the non-standard caliber was the big issue. And said, why would the Carcano freeze up and not the Mosin? But I was just trying to maneuver him around here, but it didn't really work. But he's pretty good at dodging stuff, I'll give him that. But he, like, I understand, like the caliber was weird, so they, like, I don't think we would want to, like, issue them to, like, a frontline unit that was, you know, was it Mannerheim line or whatever that, they had a bunch of guys on it, and they all had Mosins or Finnish equivalents or whatever, using similar calibers, or ones that could use all basically the same ammo. But then you put guys in that have, like, this weird gun that use weird caliber, that use these weird clips, that use, like, why would you do that? Like, why wouldn't you just give them to, like, second-line troops that guard, like, something that they're not really going to get into a shooting at somebody with it, and then they can give up their gun to go to the front or something? Like, that's, to me, that seems like a lot more reasonable. Why? And they had fixed sights, which apparently the Finns weren't big fans of and stuff, too, and things like that. So I'm not buying that they freeze solid. Like, any bolt action will freeze solid if you put oil in it or something, like at really low temperatures. So, anyway, so he replies back, he said, they buy bullets with rifles, so that not the biggest issue not functioning was. And I was like, well, yeah, I just covered that. It's like, yeah, you got ammo you bought with the gun, but it's a weird caliber that when you run out of it, then it causes major issues or for supply. It's like, oh, bringing up ammo to the front. Oh, look, you got some weird gun that has weird ammo. Like, that's, to me, that just seems like a dumb idea. Like, just complicating your supply chain just seems like a great idea. And then he says, Mosin has a little, what's it, bit bigger tolerances than Carcano, and I think better feed system, especially Finnish versions. Well, the only difference is they, well, majority of the Finnish ones are not different at all. The M39 has little dimples they put in it so it stops it from trying to, I think it mostly stops the jamming from rim lock or something or other. Anyway, I think I've done videos on that. I'm trying to figure out how the little dimples help affect that, but I'm not sure if I actually figured it or not. But so, but the Carcano, like, what tolerances the Carcano have that's, it's way super tighter than a Mosin? Like, yeah, I know the Mosin bolt's made out of multiple parts and it's kind of flops around a bit, or it's a bit, you know, whatever. But to get rubbery bolt or whatever that they said about it. But the Carcano bolt, it doesn't have, like, has the two locking lugs on the front. It doesn't have any guide ribs. It doesn't have, like, the bolt doesn't hardly touch anything. Like, the one lug runs on in the one raceway. Like, there's hardly anything going on there. Like, what's, if you don't fill the bolt with grease or oil or something, maybe they didn't clean all the grease out of them or oil out of them when they got them from Italy, because they were all brand new guns when they got them, because they had just made them. And the Italians never used them. I think they were pretty much all new. So they said didn't take the packing grease out of them, and they were like, oh, look, it didn't work. Go figure. But I can't see how the Carcano would get messed up. The Italians used it in Russia. And I don't know, did they have, like, big-time trouble with them freezing up at Stalingrad and stuff? They had all kinds of other issues. I don't think their rifles, their Carcanos freezing up was one of them, but maybe they didn't like the hole in the bottom of the mag. Snow and stuff got into it, or I don't know. Anyway, there's probably all kinds of other reasons why the Finns didn't like the Carcano, but I don't think the bolt freezing shot was probably not one of them. So, because even Lee Enfield, like up north in Canada, like if you take the oil out of the bolt when you go into like cold temperatures so it doesn't get sticky and stuff, like it's just whatever. Anyway. So I said, they got ammo with the guns, but it's still an odd caliber. So I went over that. I said, if tolerances is a problem, why do German Mausers and Swedish Mausers work just fine in cold weather? You know, like if they're, most of them are fairly tight fitting, you know, if that's the issue. So his reply is, Mauser action is best of world, maybe that's why. I'm like, so I replied to that, he's like, that's not really an answer, but okay. So they wasn't going anywhere with this guy. He didn't have really any proof of what he was saying, and they just, oh, the gun froze up, that's why they didn't like it. So, like, I understand there was probably a reason why they didn't like the guns, but like, the way I'd see it is that it was a weird caliber with weird fixed sights that the Finns weren't really used to, or their way of military thinking wasn't, you know, because all their guns had longer range sights on them, I think, like their, most of the rifles they built, because they actually shot at quite a few longer ranges in some cases. And, so you just give it to second line people, and then that frees up, like, that's, all kinds of countries have done that, like, that's, anyway. I just found this kind of humorous, but he did his damnedest to you know, defend that was the reason, or argue that was the reason the Carcano sucked ass, because it temperatures, it would freeze up and not work anymore. But anyway, doesn't get that cold here, so I can't test that. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and hope you enjoyed looking at the cartridges. These aren't 735. I got some somewhere, but couldn't find them. You say look at 6.5, good enough, I guess. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.